So let's talk layer shifts. When your 3D print is going all perfectly well, and then for some reason, for a fraction of a second, your stepper motor clicks, and all of a sudden, your entire print has shifted a little bit and it's ruined. And then your printer continues printing as if nothing has happened. So what gives? Layer shifts are annoying because they're very difficult to catch, and it's hard to find out why they happen. So that's why we've trained QuinlyVision to detect layer shifts. Because it's always watching your print, it'll be able to show you the recording as the layer shift happens so you can find out what went wrong. I'm Steven from 3DQ, and today's video is the 4th out of 14 on our video series detailing the different failure modes of QuinlyVision AI, our 3D print supervisor. Layer shifts are hard to detect with AI. They aren't as catastrophic as spaghetti, and they can be kind of subtle sometimes. In some cases, they'll even look like the normal 3D print. So today, I'll talk about what layer shifts are, how QuinlyVision detects them, and what you can do to prevent them from happening on your 3D prints. So a layer shift is a misalignment between your layers. So when your 3D printer is printing, and at some point a motor loses its position, then your print will be shifted in some direction in the X or Y direction, and that's what we call a layer shift. And a layer shift can be minor or severe, and in severe cases, it'll look like there's spaghetti and drooping on one end of the layer shift, and on the other, you'll see stuff like exposed infill from the previous layers. On more minor cases of layer shifting, the only real indication is just a little bit of a shift in the print geometry. So if something is continuing up in one direction, and then it shifts a little bit, and then it keeps on going, that's how you can kind of tell that a layer shift has happened. And these are the same things that QuinlyVision looks for when it detects the layer shifts. So first of all, QuinlyVision looks for a shift in the printed layers. So if something is continuing straight and it moves slightly to one side or the other, that's an indication that there's a layer shift in that location. Another thing it looks for is the drooping effect on one end of the print and the exposed infill on the other side of the print. And sometimes, due to the camera angle, you won't be able to see both at the same time. So that's why it sometimes has to look at a combination of both the shifting effect and the drooping or exposed infill. So QuinlyVision will analyze your G-code to determine if what it's seeing is actually a layer shift. So what it does is it looks at your current layer and your previous layer and it compares them. If they're about the same geometry, the layers are nicely stacked on top of each other, and if it detects a layer shift, it probably is a layer shift. But if the current layer is very different from the previous layer, then it might not be a layer shift and it might actually just be part of the print. So it uses some G-code analysis to help refine the results of QuinlyVision. So why do layer shifts happen? Well, layer shifts happen when your stepper motor loses a step. And this can happen for a few different reasons, but the most common one is when the nozzle crashes into something that's already been printed. Your nozzle can't move through a part, so something has to give. And usually it's the stepper motor. And it doesn't damage the motor because those motors are designed to be able to take a few missed steps, no problem, but it does ruin your print. If the reason for the layer shift is your nozzle crashing into a printed part, one thing that you can check is to make sure that your part is getting enough cooling. Because what can happen if your part doesn't get enough cooling is that the printed area can kind of curl up a little bit, and your nozzle will crash into that curled up area. Another reason for layer shifts is acceleration. So on a lot of printers, the y-axis moves the entire bed back and forth. And if your acceleration for your y-axis is too high, that can create too big of a force for the motor to overcome due to the inertia of the bed. So lowering your accelerations down in X and Y would be a good idea if you are having layer shifts. Finally, another reason for layer shifts are loose components or backlash in your mechanism. Check for belt tension. You'd want your belts to be pretty tight. Not too tight, but pretty tight. There's a lot of guides online you can search up. And you can also check for any backlash in your X and Y axis. So make sure the gears on your stepper motor are firmly attached. And make sure that all parts of your X and Y axis are firmly screwed together, because they can loosen over time due to vibrations and such. So layer shifts can sometimes be an early warning sign for a worse kind of fail. So if a layer shift happens, sometimes the part will actually detach from the bed after a few layers due to all the buildup and spaghetti that can result from a layer shift, especially a more severe one. So if QuinlyVision catches a layer shift, then that prevents something like a full part detach and spaghetti from occurring, which can actually cause damage to your printer. Spaghetti can get tangled into your motion system. If you have a print farm, then the spaghetti can drop down into other printers and ruin everything. So it's a good thing to be able to detect layer shifts early. And some printers come with crash detection on the stepper motors, but what we found is more often than not, it'll just cause the printer to keep crashing again in the same spot. It doesn't always save the print, so it's actually better just to stop the print and fix the underlying issue. So it's really helpful that QuinlyVision can detect layer shifts. It actually makes automated 3D printing better because we can detect a layer shifted part, and instead of continue printing it, we can just stop the print, wait for the bed to cool down, knock it off, and print something else in the queue. So Quinly's UI has a queuing system that accepts multiple different G-code files of different parts. And so if one of them is tending to layer shift a lot, we can just scrap that and automatically just print something else. If you want to try QuinlyVision out for yourself, try our demo, which is linked in the description. And that's it for today. So thank you for watching. Remember to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video.